Captain's log. Sea date, October 21st century. We are discovering more and more of these haunted attractions as we near Halloween, particularly in the Pittsburgh area. So we've decided to investigate them one by one. An unusual stop in a place called Uniontown, near Pittsburgh, moving in to investigate further.
Haunted Hills Estate Screen Park started about 17 years ago as Haunted Hills Estate. It was a small family-owned haunted farm type deal with a small trail in the woods and maybe a couple rooms here and there in the haunted barn that you would walk through. A very old school, old-fashioned haunt, but it got very creative with what it was doing. They never really advertised much. They didn't have big sets, big money, big props, but what they did instead of that is they were innovative. In our woods this year, we have four separate attractions. You start off with the burial, which is a kind of old-fashioned Night of the Living Dead style cemetery, very Romero influenced, with a little bit of New Orleans Gothic mausoleums in it. The whole thing revolves around the story of this ancient Indian burial ground with this character called the Spirit, which has the head of a raven and the wings of a raven, but the body of a man, and is cursed to kill anyone who trespasses onto the property after dark. So the second attraction you go to in our woods is called the Dead Woods, and what that is it is Fall Halloween Farm Central. You have this pumpkin character, the pumpkin god Kerbis, who rules over the land, and there was this curse placed on the woods by a witch, and this witch is there creating these pumpkin creatures and bringing these scarecrows to life to massacre those who trespass in the woods. And it's just kind of like that stereotypical nostalgic Halloween, lots of pumpkins, lots of hay bales, jack-o'-lanterns. It's really a nice Halloween experience, but then we throw that out the window when you enter into our third haunted attraction in the woods, which is Sin Creek. Sin Creek is a town of these down-home, backwoods inhabitants, I will say, as the most politically correct way to say it.
Anything like this?
Huh?
Anything like that?
It's actually very much like that. Jethro over here is one that tried to make it out of the town, but unfortunately it's one of those towns where if you leave, you die. And that's almost exactly what happens. And you start to catch on to the fact that something's not quite right here, even more than face value. And then after that, you come up to the top of the hill and you walk through Quarantine. Quarantine, which is our uphill corn maze, and you can get lost in there for, I personally work here, and I get lost in there for about 20 minutes minimum. So it's craziness, and it's just you, the corn, and whatever's working in there trying to get you. We had to find some way to offer some normalcy in the fall. You know, all the county fairs around here got canceled. Pretty much every leisure event or entertainment event in general has been canceled in most places across the country. So we took it upon ourselves to find some way, even if we couldn't open the haunted attraction, to provide some entertaining normalcy to the area for fall. And we were very lucky that we were able to meet the guidelines with not too much heading. There was a decent amount of work that went into it, of course. We had to restructure a lot of the way that we operate. We had to restructure a lot of the scenes and the ways the attractions operate, but we were able to pull it off, and we have a safe, scary experience here that you and your family can come to for some Halloween fun. In addition to that, we also have a partnership with Sterator Sanitation, which is owned by Gene and Tony Sterator, who are very, very great guys and popular around here. And we have, I believe, 8 different sanitation stations, completely complimentary for our guests here, located in our midway. On top of that, we have a zombie hazmat crew, which walks around nightly, and every 20 minutes, they're cleaning. They're cleaning every contact surface, every touch surface, and we're making sure everything's sanitary and completely safe. We also do enforce social distancing on our guidelines waiting lines in the best ways that we can. The place has definitely expanded. Like I said before, it was just, for the longest time, a small trail through the woods, and we have 101 acres on this property. We have so much space to work with. And it's not one of those places where we rent a space, so we have to be, we have to set up in September and have it all down by November. We keep adding and keep adding and keep adding throughout the year. We work full time here doing it. So in just 2 years, it's expanded to 6 individual haunted house attractions while you're here, plus midway games, plus axe throwing, plus concession stands. And then we have the haunt shop here, which is our massive gift shop that you walk through when you exit.
And is he your store manager?
Yes, this is Bob. Bob didn't do too good of a job last year, so we made him a prop. So unfortunately, this is what we do with our not so great employees.
Any complaints go to Bob.
Any complaints go to Bob.
Pirate approved! A night of thrills and chills this Halloween season. See you there!